Happiness is a choice. Sadness is a choice. We choose the emotions we want to feel, whether consciously or subconsciously, whether directly or indirectly. Hi, my friends. I'm Daniel. This is Psychology Teachings. And today we're going to be talking about happiness, or really any emotion, and how we ourselves pick which emotion we want to feel, whether we know we're doing it or we don't. So let's say an event happens, right? And let's say you see someone running across the street, horrible accident, they get hit by a car. Our immediate emotion is we gasp, is we might feel frightened, our heart is gonna beat, we might feel scared, we might feel upset. Let's say we know this individual, maybe he's our friend, maybe someone close to us, we're gonna feel extremely upset. Now, before everyone starts jumping on this video, I'm not saying that you shouldn't feel upset. Right? I'm not saying that, you know, certain situations, yes, I understand. Something like that dramatic happens, naturally you're going to feel upset. But when we're talking about taking accountability and about choosing, what happens afterwards? Let's fast forward past the accident. Let's say this was someone very close to you. Something absolutely awful happens to them. Do you turn to alcohol? Do you turn to staying inside and mourning forever? I'm not saying it's bad to mourn, by all means, right? It's important for the mind to heal. It's important to take your time and to not rush through things. But I'm a huge believer in, you just saw something absolutely terrible happen. And now you can choose, after the event has occurred, after you've given your initial sadness, if you will, how are you going to respond now? So it's done. The event's over with. Do you go work out? Do you still go to work? Go out with your friends afterwards? Do you still keep going at life? Keep going strong? Keep staying productive? Don't get me wrong. You're not being ignorant. You're not forgetting the situation. In that time period, you're there for them. You mourn. You help. You do whatever you have to do. But you don't stay in that box. Why? Because you choose not to. We choose what emotions we want to feel. When you're going out, sometimes amazing things can happen to you. And you can choose to feel happy. People will ask the positive people in their lives, how are you happy all the time? You know, how do you always have a smile on your face? Because the people who always have a smile on their face, they choose to be happy. They want to be happy. It sucks being unhappy. So yeah, when given the choice, they will choose. Me being a part of those people, I will 100% choose to be happy than unhappy if I'm in the correct mental state. What do I mean by mental state? It means if I don't have a headache, if I'm full, if lots of these physiological things are going my way. It's a lot easier to pick what emotion you want to feel. Now you're going to look at me and go, Daniel, if you're saying this is an option, that we can choose our emotions, why would anyone in their right mind, why would any sane individual voluntarily pick to be upset? I'll tell you why. Sometimes it's the only thing they know how to do. Depending on how they've grown up, the environment that they're surrounded by, maybe the people that they look up to, the role models, maybe that's just all they know. No matter what happens, negativity always finds a way to creep in for them. And they're always upset. They always find things to be upset about. And then it takes a whole different point where it's not even reasonable things anymore. I mean, they're being upset at things which would make the regular person go, what? You're upset about that? Really? You know the person, you know. I got 98% on my last test. You can choose. You can be happy. 98, that's phenomenal. Hey, that's incredible. Good, the studying paid off for 98. Man, I was 2% away from 100%. This sucks. We get to pick our emotions. A lot of the time, something will happen, and it'll happen very quickly and very suddenly. All right, let's say someone bumps into you, shoulders you accidentally. Your immediate emotion might be, who does this guy think he is? What a jerk. Why would he do that? You might not say that out loud, depending on your personality, but you'll definitely think it. But then, you can choose how to feel about it. You can choose to be pissed off, to add fuel to the fire, go, this son of a, who does he think he is? Does he think he owns this coffee shop? Blah, 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 blah. Or you can choose and go, you know what? Who cares? It's probably an accident. I know he wasn't gunning for me. He wasn't sitting over there going, I see Daniel, I'm going to go up and purposely shoulder him. But no, man, it was an accident. Whatever. Are you going to let that ruin your day? That is a gift on itself. Being able to go throughout your day, being able to pick your emotions, and being able to control your day, whether it's going to be a good day or a bad day. Now, a lot of the times, our immediate reactions, this is due to a part of our brains. It's called the amygdala. The amygdala is basically the emotional control in the entire brain. This is what's responsible for zapping out the emotions. And a lot of the times in certain situations, that involuntarily, just like heartbeat that we don't control, just like our intestines working, we don't voluntarily control, right? They work on their own. Your brain fires off an emotion, and it is a skill to be able to get that emotion, interpret it, be able to consciously realize, be like, whoa, I'm on edge. I'm on edge. I feel tense, feel stressed. I'm almost in fight or flight mode. I feel like I should say something to the guy. And then in that moment, you have to pick and go, okay, are we going to keep fueling the fire? Can we relax and take this another route? You choose how you want to feel. And a lot of the times, this is where logical thinking and emotional thinking come head to head. See, 90% of the time, emotionally, we don't even know. We're not even in control of our reactions. But after conscious thought and effort is put into it, you can train yourself over and over again to master your reactions. Imagine this. You're at a coffee shop, right? Same scenario. Guy comes up, shoulders you, walks away. Your immediate thought is, this jerk, where does he think he is? What the hell, man? Come on, you saw me standing there. Right? And your immediate thoughts, even not directly, are going to be to start bashing this guy over what he did. Now, psychologically speaking, if individuals have the cognitive ability, they have enough mental energy left in their day. So let's say it's bright and early, it's 11 in the morning, you had a good sleep, as opposed to, let's say you just worked an 8-hour shift, then you went to the coffee shop, you don't have that same mental energy. Now, you have that mental energy, you're in the coffee shop because, let's say you didn't work, this happens. Now your brain, with practice, can look at that logically instead of emotionally. And logically will tell us this. It will say, okay, logically, does he have a problem with me personally? Do I know the guy? No. Okay, so that's out of it. Was he just born a jerk? Like, is this, maybe he just grew up like this? Maybe his parents didn't teach him. He's just used to keeping his head down and his shoulders out and just whacking into people. Or three, maybe something's up. Why can't I give him the benefit of the doubt that something happened? Maybe there's an occasion. Maybe there's something going on. All right, let's fast forward 10, 15 minutes. You're sitting down at the coffee shop with your coffee. He happens to be sitting behind you. Now you overhear him talking to his buddy. And he's saying, yeah, man, my mother just had a stroke. I have to get a flight tonight at midnight to go over to check up on her. So when you hear that, you go, oh, maybe that's why he shouldered into me. Doesn't have to be a jerk. Doesn't have to be a bad guy. In the heat of the moment, he's thinking about his mom. He's thinking about, you know, this horrible situation. And don't get me wrong. I'm not saying give it an excuse. I'm not saying let it slide and whatever. But being able to understand why an individual did what they did makes a lot more sense. For me personally, I can sleep well at night. It makes sense. Looking at something logically rather than emotionally. Going like, you know what, man? I understand why you acted the way you did. I don't approve. Let me make that very clear. I don't approve, but I understand, and that's okay. There are many, many books written about this, many things you can find on YouTube, the difference of thinking logically versus emotionally. The way that this ties into the video, folks, is when you think logically, oftentimes you can pick how to feel and how you want to respond. So this is, you're taking the involuntary controls of your mind, of the amygdala, your emotions, and you're making them voluntary. You're putting conscious effort to go, okay, how do I want to respond to this? Do I want to fight fire with fire? Do I want to take it easy? Do I want to walk away? And this is the way which we can choose what emotions we want to feel, whether it be sad, happy, anger, neutral, relaxed, anxious. So this was just a few tips that I hope that has helped me personally in my life and that I hope helped you. I hope you enjoyed this video from Psychology Teachings. I'll be uploading at least once a week, so please don't be a stranger. Come on by, give us a like, give us a subscribe, and have a wonderful day.